Okay, someone joined. Avantika madam, how are you? Okay. So, any questions from anyone? Hello, Lubna madam. How are you? Long time no see. Working too hard, great. Hello. Usually listen to recordings. That's good. That's nice. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Okay, thank you for always talking, taking the time for us. Thank you for joining every time. Okay, time is equally important for all of us, right? It is not that only my time is important, your time is not important. If you people are also giving your time, then also it is important. Okay, anyways, 12 people. I am not used to so much of crowd. Okay. Can I ask a question, please? Yes, you can. Sir, Jupiter really expand, right? Just copy your ascendant Jupiter in Virgo 11th house. Does it increase income continuously? Yeah, means the person will see a gradual increase in their income, their gains, money, throughout life. Gradual means when like they are in 20s, then they are 30s, they will see a gradual rise in their income. Okay, especially if this person also goes through Jupiter Dasha or Mercury Dasha, which is Lord of Virgo, whichever nakshatra it is in, like Jupiter in Hasta or Chitra, I think Uttara Falguni, Hasta or Chitra. It means Sun Dasha, Moon Dasha and Mars Dasha. This also indicates that person can be like having good gains during these dashas. Okay. Good evening, good evening. Namaste, namaste. What will be the effect of the upcoming Saturn retrograde for someone in Saturn Mahadasha, Saturn in 7th Libra in birth chart, transiting my 10th house? Retrograde of any planet makes us reflect back on things related with that planet. Okay, understand it like this. For you, Saturn is the 10th and 11th lord. It is exalted in your birth chart, but it is transiting retrograde in your 10th house. So there will be lots of reflection around career, lots of reflection around your income, that if I am earning well in my life, if I am in my right career, whether I need to change career, there will be lots of reflection in that matter. Likewise, whichever house Saturn rules in a person's chart, you need to you will reflect on that particular house. Saturn retrograde is from 23rd March. I might be writing during this month about Saturn retrograde, so that article may help people. Okay, so but otherwise, the generic result of Saturn retrograde is reflecting back on something, reflecting back on the Saturn related things in your chart. Maybe relationship also. Saturn is in the 7th house, Libra. Hello from Greece. Hello from India. Jupiter in 8th house is always bad. I have it in Natal and now transiting Jupiter in 8th house to 4 Cancer ascendant. I don't see that anything can be termed as always good or always bad. Even the worst placement can give you some benefic result. Even the best placement can give you some good results. Okay, so I don't consider a planet as always bad. Okay, Jupiter in 8th house can give you good amount of inheritance. Also, it can give a good amount of business benefits if you are into business. Many a times, okay, understand this thing. Okay, whenever we feel that a planet is not giving good results, it is just because you are not doing anything related with that planet. Okay, the planet is indicating towards an energy in your chart that you should be doing this thing or that thing, and you are not exploring that energy. Okay, like in this case, Jupiter is your 6th lord and 9th lord, and it is sitting in the 8th house. 8th house of serving other people, 9th house is education, knowledge. Jupiter itself is education, knowledge. 6th house is your daily work. So this person's daily work life should be about knowledge sharing, guiding and counseling people, sharing knowledge with others, helping them through his knowledge. If you are not doing anything related with this, then you will feel that Jupiter is not giving that much result. Jupiter is bad. No, Jupiter is not bad. You are in wrong direction. Just change your direction and Jupiter will do good. Okay, so every planetary energy is indicating towards something in your chart. If you start doing things related with that energy, you will find better results in your life. whenever we are stressful, we are frustrated, we feel lack of result, the only reason is that we are going against the planet. That's it. No other reason. Planet wants you to go this side, you are trying to go that side. Okay. Jupiter in Hasta, 11th house, moon in 12th house, sir. Yeah, so as I said, this Jupiter can give you good results when you are in Jupiter Dasha, Mercury Dasha or Moon Dasha. But again, 11th house is the house of entrepreneurship. The best results are coming through entrepreneurship. Any kind of business entrepreneurship, this Jupiter can give you the best results there. If you are not into entrepreneurship, then you may feel that, again, you may feel that Jupiter is not working well for you. Okay. So every planet is indicating towards an energy, and if you follow that energy, you will get better results. No matter, even Saturn can give you, Saturn debilitated can give you good results. Okay, even Saturn debilitated can give you good results. Best example is Helen Keller. Okay, legend in her field. So she realized her strength in her minimum ways. And she worked on those strength, and she got the legendary status in her life. So even a debilitated Saturn can give you good results if you are following the right path. And even an exalted Jupiter can give you bad results if you are not following the right path. Good morning from USA. Good evening from India. Hello from Poland. Hello from India. You are not in Poland, right? Anyways, can you explain how 8th house can be seen as house of helping humanity? Okay. Understand, 1st house is you, 7th house is other people. Okay, 1st house is you. Okay, my 1st house is me. 7th house are you people who are sitting there. Okay, you are my 7th house. Second house is my wealth, 8th house is other people wealth. Exactly opposite to second house is 8th house. 8th house becomes other people wealth. You will get other people wealth only when you serve other people. If I provide services to you, then only I will get wealth from you, right? So that's where 8th house becomes the house of serving other people or serving humanity, okay? That's why it is also house of business benefits. So 7th house is business, but how much person is gaining out of that business is 8th house. Thank you. What would be the effect of Jupiter Dasha in 3rd house retrograde for Scorpio Lagna? Jupiter being in Kritika, 8th house in Navamsha for Libra Navamsha. Okay, anyways, first D1 chart, where Jupiter Dasha is going on, and it is in 3rd house retrograde for Scorpio Lagna. 3rd house is business, self-efforts. If this person is in the business setup environment, again this Jupiter can give you good results. If you are not in business setup environment, then you can find difficulties. Okay, then you can find difficulties in your work environment. You may feel that, okay, I'm not getting the best of the result. You are not getting best of the result, but because you are not doing what Jupiter is telling you to do. Okay. That is where one should focus. 3rd house retrograde Scorpio, it is all about being in your own business. For Scorpio Lagna means it is in Capricorn sign. It is second lord, fifth lord in the 3rd house. It shows that your best money is coming from business setup work. Any kind of knowledge sharing business can work well for you. If you are not doing it, then you may feel that Jupiter Dasha is not giving a great result. Now, Jupiter is in 8th house in Navamsha. Navamsha is the chart of right life path. This Dasha can bring a major change in your right life path. okay, whatever life path you are following, there can be a shift from that life path during this dasha, because Jupiter is in 8th house of Navamsha. Does a planet nakshatra lord sitting in, okay, does a planet nakshatra lord sitting in 2, 6, 10, 11 make one billionaire? Okay, if Mahadasha and Antardasha lords sit in Artha houses, as other astrologers say, it will give huge money in life. Also, please explain when 6th house indicates challenges and troubles. How is it Artha houses and how does it make rich? Because to become rich, you have to face lots of obstacles, challenges. Nothing is going to be served on platter unless you are born to a like billionaire. Okay, to make your own money, you need to like put efforts and face lots of obstacles, challenges in life, then only you make money. So then this is why 6th house is the Artha houses. Again, all these houses, any house can make you billionaire. Okay, it is not that only these houses can you make you billionaire. I feel that most important house for making money is the 8th house. 8th house, as I said, is the house of other people's wealth. So 2nd house is your wealth, everyone else's wealth is in the 8th house. So if you deal with the 8th house related thing, that is the best possibility of making money. But again, people are not normally going towards the 8th house of business benefits. They are happy with their job setup work. The 10th house related thing, 11th house related thing. Now no one can be rich, no one can be a millionaire or billionaire by doing a job. There is not a single example in the whole history of humanity that a person became rich by doing a job. Okay, so a person needs to get into his own business, then only he can get into this millionaire billionaire kind of thing. If this person, whomsoever chart is, he is in business, then he can be a billionaire from any planetary position. If he is not into business, then no matter, even if Rahu Venus Jupiter are together in Pisces Revati, then also this person will face trouble in making the wealth. When does what does Saturn Mercury conjunction means for Cancer ascendant in 5th house? It can give lots of trouble in relationship matter, because 5th house is the house of relationship. Saturn has nothing to do with the relationship. Saturn is a cold planet, so it can give lots of difficulties in relationship matters. Then it also shows a person may have some communication issues. This person needs to work on his communication skills, and his communication skills will get better with time. It also shows the realization of being in a business person can come with delay and hard work, perseverance. Even the debilitated can give good result. This means that despite how much we try to explain the planet placement, it results can be totally different from a person, and no prediction can fit on it until that person experiences it. I always said so. The article which I wrote, Decoding Astrology, okay. There is no general rule in astrology that everyone with this planetary placement will give this result. Okay, and there is nothing like that. As I always say, everyone who was born with Buddha didn't become Buddha. Okay, the basic problem is that we are basic problem is that we are. Trying to interpret a chart, we are trying to interpret a planet, we are trying to interpret a house, we are trying to interpret a sign, nakshatra, dasha. We are taking everything into consideration, we are not taking the person into consideration. Okay, who is going to utilize this energy? At what level he is, at what consciousness level he is, that is where the biggest point is. if he is not that conscious, okay, if he is not that evolved, then even the best planetary placement can give the trouble. We have seen I have written enough about Mark David Chapman, the person who had four exalted planets, okay, and all he ended up in doing is killing John Lennon. When you have strong horses in your chariot, you need a strong charioteer also. You need a strong chariot driver also, who can who can hold on to the energy and the strength of the strong horses. So if you have exalted planet, you need a higher evolved soul also, who can handle the energy of exalted planet. Likewise, even if planets are debilitated and the person is evolved, he can still utilize that that debilitated planet energy in his favor. It may take some time, it may take some more hard work, more efforts, but he will eventually get it, okay. So there is no general rule. There is no general rule in astrology that, okay, if someone has Saturn debilitated, he is going to suffer whole of life. If someone is having Saturn in Leo, I have Saturn in Leo in my 10th house with Rahu, still I have a career. Still I have a recognition. Still I am a little bit of famous. I won't say I am hugely famous, but I am still famous. Okay. So 10th house has still given me the result, just because I tried to follow my 10th house related indication. 10th lord is in the third house. I should be in my own business. I was working job setup. I resigned from there. I came here and I got the result. Okay. So it all depends on the person who is utilizing that energy. Nothing else. There is nothing like, okay, it is written in your chart, you will not be successful ever, or if it is written in your chart that you, no matter what, you will become a millionaire. Nothing like that. Okay, it depends on the person who is utilizing that energy. Sun and Ketu in 8th house, Pisces, Leo rising. Whenever Sun is with Rahu and Ketu, it is where the person is born. Person is born in eclipse time period, and as Sun represents your overall career, okay. As Sun represents your overall career, authority, recognition, this person will realize his right career with certain delay in life. Maybe in 30s, till 30s, they will be under illusion that, okay, I should follow this career or that career, whether I should go into this field or that path, nothing. From 30s onwards, they will have start having realization that, okay, this is my path, then this is what I should be following. It also gives troubles with father or any authority figure. Son is authority figure, son is also father. And Ketu is separation, so they can have high level of separation from their father. Okay, they may be like separated physically. They are not staying with their father, or they are having this differences of opinion, disagreements kind of thing. But 8th house is also a cult. Good things about Sun Ketu in 8th house Pisces is that this person can be research oriented. This person can be like a very good occultist, mystic and all. So that's where the benefits can come of this 8th house Sun Ketu. Okay. Then Venus is retrograde and sitting with Sun in the 4th house. For Cancer ascendant, Venus is retrograde and sitting with Sun. It means in Libra, and in D9 chart, Venus is with Mars in third house for Pisces ascendant. What would be the result of Venus dasha? Also, Jupiter aspecting Venus in D1 with ninth aspect. Again, Venus is in 4th house Libra. 4th house is home or private offices. Libra is sign of business. So this person will get best result during Venus Dasha when he is in any kind of business setup of work. Okay. If this person is not in business setup of work, then like average result, okay, and the normal result of job setup, career and all, that will be there. But best result will be from business setup of work, home based business, private office based business, that should be the path for this person. In D9, Venus is with Mars in the third house for Pisces ascendant. Again, it is in Taurus sign in third house. Again, it is indicating towards the same. D9 is the chart of right life path. If this person goes into right life path of business setup work, then he will get the result. If he doesn't go there, then we cannot expect that much of result. Then the average results will be there. Mercury Atmakaraka in 5th house with Lagna Lord Ketu Dasha. Mercury Atmakaraka in 5th house with Lagna Lord Ketu Dasha, sir. Mercury Ketu together in Pisces, I guess. Jupiter being in the 8th Gemini Parivartan with Mercury. This is this is a very good placement for someone in occult research or spiritual field. Mercury Ketu together in Pisces, this person can be highly imaginative, creative, and as Pisces is spirituality and hidden matters. Jupiter is also in Gemini sign in 8th house. Jupiter is also indicating towards good gains from hidden matters. This person can do very well in any research oriented field. Okay, this person can do very well in any research oriented field, and occult, mysticism, spirituality, creativity, imagination, good gains from that. Okay, anyways, Scorpio ascendant is always about this kind of thing, occult and mysticism. So it should help this person. Thank you. You're welcome. Okay. How is Mars Rahu Dasha for Gemini Lagna? Rahu in the second and Mars in the third. Please advise. Again, the same thing. Mars is in the third house. Okay. Mars is in the third house. Gemini Lagna means it is in Leo sign. Good dignity. Third house is business and communication. Mars is like your 11th lord and the 6th lord. 6th house is your 6th house is your daily work life. 11th house is your income, and Mars is sitting in the 3rd house. It shows that person's daily work life should be in the business setup where he is getting the best money. So if this person is in business setup, then best income. If he is not in business setup, he can have issues with authority figures, because same 3rd house becomes 6th from the 10th, conflict with the authority figures. He can have issues with the authority figures. Main dasha is of Mars, so let's consider Mars only. Okay, it doesn't matter if Rahu is in Rahu is dispositor of Moon. Rahu dispositor in 11, Moon Rahu in 2nd, so it is in Virgo Hasta. No, this person has to get into his own business to get the best results. So if he continues into a job setup and all, then the problems will be. Mars and Rahu in Capricorn in 6th house from Moon in Leo rising. 6 from Moon in Leo rising. Bit known. What is it? Bit known. Divna madam. Anyways, Mars Rahu together in Capricorn shows that It is a good position for any authority, for any recognition. Mars Rahu can make someone very much gravitated, ambitious. Okay, Mars is all about approaching something and going towards something, and Rahu is further further enhancing that quality. So in Capricorn is the sign of authority, recognition. This person may desire lots of authority and recognition. Moon in Leo, rising not unknown. So it is sixth from the moon, okay, sixth from the moon. So mind wise this person can be very ambitious, can be very much gravitating towards achieving next goal, next recognition. So this person is a go-getter kind of person, okay, very active, very agile. Very difficult to see this person sitting idle, okay, that is where. But sixth house is also the house of disputes, conflicts. Person can become a very good lawyer with this this planetary position, Mars Rahu in Capricorn in the sixth from the moon. At least mentally he will be inclined towards legal career. We can have better analysis if we know the rising sign. Thank you, you're welcome. Mars in the seventh house can make problem for business. It depends on the dignity. Seventh house is mainly the partnership business. If at all there is a problem in business, it can be in partnership business. It may not be in sole proprietorship. Okay, so Mars in seventh house, if dignity wise it is weak, then we can say they can have issues with their partners. But if they are having Mars in good dignity in seventh house, then it is shows that person can still have good gains from business, even partnership business. Exalted Mars in ninth house, what shows for father? Exalted Mars in ninth house, so it is Taurus ascendant. Okay, Taurus ascendant people have natural difficulties with father, because 10th house of father, I consider 10th house as father. Okay, if in case you are thinking that 9th house is the house of father, then I don't consider it. I consider it as 10th house as father, for the simple logic that 4th house is your mother, her husband will be your father. Okay, so 10th house should be the father. So for Taurus ascendant, what happens that Saturn and Rahu co-rule the 10th house of Aquarius, of father for them. So they always have difficulties with father, difficulties or like a distant relationship. They are not necessarily difficulty if Saturn is in good dignity, like Saturn is in Libra or something like that, then they can have a long distance relationship with their father. They are staying somewhere else, their father is staying somewhere else, but still they are having good communication between them. But if Saturn is weak, then there can be long term difficulties with father. Okay, so that is the thing. Mars in the ninth house shows that person can have a kind of adamant approach towards his views and belief system, that my religion is the best, my belief system is the best, and everyone else's religion is crap. That kind of stuff can happen with Mars coming with Jupiter or ninth house. Mars is exalted in the seventh, right? So as Mars is in good dignity, this person can gain out of business. But as I said, if this person is partnership business will also work, but partnership business will also work, but this person will have gains from business. Okay, What will be the good time or ideal position of planets to change job as per astrology? Whenever 5th and 9th house are getting activated together, and 5th house is the house, 5th house is house of change of work environment, 9th house is the house of loss of work environment, like resignations and all. So when these two houses are active simultaneously in Dasha, that can bring the opportunity. And then in transits also, if it is if these houses are getting activated during transit, like transiting planets are also impacting these houses, then it is more potential that you can get an opportunity to change the job. So 5th and 9th house and their dashas transits are more important. 8th house is always the house of major changes, so we can consider 8th house also. Mars and Saturn exchange Saturn Venus in 7. What is the question? Exalted Mars in Mars and Saturn. This is not a good exchange. Saturn is in Scorpio. Okay. At least not for relationship matters. They can have troubles with father, troubles with any authority figure. Now, even when they, because 10th house represents your authority figures, it is 10th house is like your authority figure, either at home or at work. At home your father, at work your boss. And when its lord is in Scorpio, the sign of instability, no matter if Mars is debilitated or not, Mars is exalted or not, then this person can will have some troubles with authority figures, both at both places, at home, at work. Then Mercury Rahu conjunction in 8th house of D10 chart for Sagittarius ascendant, what does it mean for career? I prefer to look at D1 chart first, then I go into D10. From this information I can only tell that Mercury Dasha or Rahu Dasha or Moon Dasha can bring a major change in person's career, because it is 8th house of D10 chart. Major change in your career path. Okay, so that's what I feel. Okay. For job change, do we need to check Lagna or Moon chart for 5th and 9th house planets activation? Thank you. I always consider Lagna. Lagna remains important. As I always feel and say that Lagna represents your events in life. The Moon shows your mindset. Okay. The Moon shows your mindset. Okay, so if you are looking for the event of job change, then look at from ascendant. If you are looking when your mind will feel like having a job change, then look for Moon. Okay, that Moon and Saturn conjunction makes people workaholic. Yeah, we can say so. Moon is mind, Saturn is duty and responsibility. They can be very dutiful. They realize with time, understand, as Moon, which represents mind, is with Saturn, which is delay, hard work and perseverance. They realize with time that nothing is happening in their life without putting efforts. So they have to put an extra effort, which may eventually makes them workaholic. What combination can make someone win lotto? Eighth lord is in second house, or eighth lord in 11th house. Second and 11th are money oriented houses. Eighth house is lotteries, speculative business. So if eighth lord is in good dignity and it is also a benefic planet, then it can indicate someone having good gains from lottery or speculative business. Feel it is true in my case. Thank you. I am Cancer ascendant going through Venus Mahadasha, Venus Antardasha, Venus in Pisces in my ninth house. Okay. Because of Saturn and Jupiter transit in 7th and 8th house, is there any chance of job change or new job or job with relocation? What other details should I check in my chart to know this? As I said, for job change, this Venus Mahadasha, Venus Antardasha, Venus is in 9th house. Yeah, the 9th house is getting activated now. You need to see when your fifth house is also getting activated, like Venus Venus Mars period or Venus Venus Ketu period can be important in bringing the job opportunity. The 10th sorry 8th lord is Saturn, so even like Venus Venus Saturn period can also bring the possibility. Between September to November, Saturn Jupiter will be together in Capricorn again. So it is 7th from the 7th, so that sorry 10th from the 10th, 7th house, Bhavad Bhavam of 10th house of career. So again, it can bring some opportunities. It can bring some opportunities for job change or career development and all. So you can have some interviews, offer letters coming at that time. But again, it is based on this much information which I have got. I can help better if I look at the whole chart. Okay. Capricorn rising Saturn in rising Saturn in Cancer, Moon in Venus in 8th house, Leo. Person got inheritance from Venus in 8th. How is relationship? Venus is in Leo. Okay, Saturn is in Cancer. Okay, so like in relationship matters, they will have a like lots of frustration, lots of dissatisfaction in their relationship matters. And Venus in Leo. Leo is the sign of your ego, as it is ruled by Sun, and Venus is relationship, ego and relationship together, which cannot exist together. So they can have lots of ego clashes in relationship. Always give away so much free knowledge. Should we feel guilty for asking you so many questions here? No. I am doing my job, you are doing your job, nothing else. Only ego feels guilty, only ego feels hurt. Okay, so if you are feeling guilty, retrospect somewhere, ego is sitting. Okay, otherwise there is no reason to feel guilty about. Everything is God's grand game that is going on. Okay, so nothing to feel guilty about. But you can find out with this sort of feeling. If you are feeling guilty, just reflect back, look inside you. There you will find out your ego. Because understand, this feeling of guilty is coming because you are not accepting God's wish. It may be God's wish that I am doing these sessions, you are asking questions and I am answering you. I never felt guilty of replying to your questions free of cost. Why you are feeling guilty? Enjoy. Enjoy as long as it is going on. We never know in these times. Okay. Rahu in 9th house means lack of luck. I don't think so. Okay. All we can say that person can have luck in foreign lands, can have luck with people of different ethnicity. That is a possibility with Rahu in 9th house. They may feel, okay, understand, when Rahu is in the 9th house, they may feel that they are not lucky, but that is not the case. Everyone has luck somewhere. They may have in foreign lands and with people of different ethnicity. Your sharing of knowledge is priceless. Blessings to you. Same to you, sir. Your joining is also priceless. What placements make someone selfish? Moon in the first house. We can also say Venus in the first house. But largely what I have seen is Moon in the first house. Unless it is exalted in Taurus, then it is a different thing. But otherwise, Moon in the first house, especially like Moon in first house in Aries. Understand the reason Moon is mind, first house is self. Mind is not able to move away from self in any condition. They will always think about themselves first, their own survival. Okay. They are not concerned with whatever is happening in the world. Their needs should be fulfilled. That is Moon in the first house. Badhak or Maraka planets in Gandhanta, how to expect results? Again, it depends on what is Vadak planet, what is Maraka planets, is their dignity. It is just not possible for me to give a like generic result that okay, all the Vadak planets, all the Maraka planets in Gandhanta position in any sign will give this kind of result. Okay. The generic feeling of Gandhanta is like a drowning. Then the person may feel emotional drowning. But it is more so when like the Gandhanta point is in Cancer sign, water signs, and the planets are like Moon and Venus. We are more relationship oriented planets. That's where the person feels like getting drowned in their activity, in their results. Okay. Person may feel that emotionally he is losing everything. In Venus case, it may feel that their romantic relationships are going nowhere, or they are losing the control of their romantic relationship. But this cannot be generalized for every planet and whatever dignity it is. Dear sir, dear madam, Venus, Jupiter, Ketu, Dasha running. Venus, Jupiter, Ketu, Dasha. Okay, Lagna, Libra, Swati. Venus is in Capricorn, 4th house, Jupiter in Gemini, in 9th house, and Ketu in Scorpio, in 2nd house. What do you think about? Thanks in advance. So first of all, Venus, Jupiter, Ketu, Dasha, if we just consider Venus, Jupiter, okay, they both are teachers, they both are benefic planet. I am in Jupiter, Venus, Dasha, so you can see the kind of results I am getting. I am getting results out of sharing my knowledge, guiding and counseling people. So Venus, Jupiter, Dasha, both are teachers. This Dasha will give you the best result when you are sharing your knowledge with people, whatsoever your knowledge is, your academic knowledge, creative knowledge, any field. Okay. लिब्रा लग्न, योर लग्न इज एक्टिव, लग्न लॉर्ड इज इन द फोर्थ हाउस ऑफ होम और प्राइवेट ऑफिसेस, यू शुड वर्क फ्रॉम होम और प्राइवेट ऑफिसेस टू गेट द बेस्ट रिजल्ट. जुपिटर इन नाइन्थ हाउस जेमिनाई, नेचुरल टीचर, नेचुरल गाइड, काउंसलर. जुपिटर रूल्स द थर्ड हाउस ऑफ बिजनेस कम्युनिकेशन, यू शुड टीच पीपल, काउंसिल पीपल. केतु इन स्कॉर्पियो इन सेकेंड हाउस शोज in your very early childhood there can be lots of major transformations happening in family. There can be lots of changes happening in family, but it can also make you a very research oriented person. So best thing to do during this dasha, Venus Jupiter dasha, especially in Venus dasha, as you as Venus is also your lagna lord, first of all it can be a good dasha if you are working from home or private offices and business setup. If you are working somewhere else, then average type of result, but still this dasha will be good for you. Venus dasha financially it is always good. We may have troubles in relationship matters and all, but financially it is always good. Please keep these sessions going. Look forward to them every week, even if I only listen later. You're welcome. Sure, I will try. As long as God is playing its grand play. I heard about moon Magha first pada causing death of mother. Again, we cannot make a generic rule that everyone who has moon in Magha in first pada will lose his mother. It is too generic to say. There are different houses which are responsible for death of the mother, and it should be utilized. This part of knowledge should be utilized only when there are bilkul like dire circumstances. Okay, where you have no other option, like someone is on deathbed. Okay, I remember I gave death timing consultations before. But those are the situations where, like if I give an example, last year during this COVID situation, one person was in some other country and his mother was in some other country. And due to this COVID situation, flights were very less. So he wanted to know, because his mother was terminally ill, he wanted to know when he should go for to visit her. When is the time for her? In that circumstances, I utilize this part of knowledge, but it should not be utilized for every other reason or for every other person. Capricorn ascendant Jupiter in the sixth house, daily work life in knowledge sharing, any kind of knowledge sharing, guiding and counseling type of work, this person should work. Then while doing job change, will it be risky if planets in the fifth and ninth are conjugated or aspected with Rahu, Ketu or Saturn during current transit, because there may be something which may arise as surprise after planets movements to other houses. Need your insights, thank you. It can happen, but understand another thing, that job setup is always surprising. You may after 2-3 months of honeymoon period, every job becomes like the earlier job only. Okay, so you go in any company of the world, okay, you will that is very natural. I am not saying specifically about you, for human race. Understand, we are born free, and when we are in job setup, we are working under someone else. Okay, no matter, even if you become a manager, senior manager, partner or director, nothing, there is always someone sitting over you. In that scenario, you will always find the difficulty in working under others. So in that scenario, you may change different jobs, but after 2-3 months of initial joining period, you will get into the same mess again and again. Okay. That's why, like, having your own business is always better than getting into this job setup. Jupiter in 7th in Mula Nakshatra, if situations permit. I understand there can be situations where we need to do job. Like, I was in the job setup work when the situation demanded that. I was going through that phase where I was working in job setup. But when I my time changed, I shifted into business because I thought that I can take this much of a risk in my life. Jupiter in 7th house in Mula Nakshatra, Gandanta for Gemini Lagna. In relationship matters, they can have a feeling of drowning. In relationship matters, they can have I'm losing control of my relationship. Relationships are not working as I like to. But Jupiter in Mula Nakshatra always brings some karmic relationships in life. So those relationships are always difficult. Why is Mangalik advised to marry Mangalik only? I don't know. My views on marriage and astrology are completely different. You marry anyone, you will have same troubles. Okay, for any person, not only specifically for you, for any person. Marry a Mangalik, marry a non-Mangalik, issues will be the same. Virgo Lagna, Saturn Mahadasha, Mercury Antardasha will end in October. After that, how will be my Saturn Mahadasha, Ketu Antardasha? Saturn Atmakarka in 3rd house, Ketu in 1st house, Mercury in 6th house. Saturn Ketu, understand one thing, that Saturn Ketu, if you just look at their nature, Saturn is Saturn is limitation, Ketu is separation. So none of them is a provider, okay? None of them provides anything in this for anyone. Saturn is limiting the results, and Ketu is separating you from the results. So this dasha cannot bring any gains and achievement. I am trying to say this dasha is not a time period where you can look for your ambitions to be fulfilled. Okay, so just try to sail through this dasha. Then Saturn is your Atmakarka in 3rd house. Try to get into business. That's where you are going to get the best results. Okay. What about Ketu Dasha for Magha Ascendant? Ketu is all about separation, all about letting go. Okay, Ketu Dasha always, normally people say that Ketu is, Ketu Dasha is a difficult one to go through. It is because our basic nature is directly in conflict with Ketu's basic nature. Ketu is all about letting go. Our human nature is all about holding things or collecting things or holding or clinging on to the people. If you are trying to hold on to people or the things, then Ketu Dasha can be very difficult, because Ketu will create circumstances where you have to let go of something or someone. If you are ready to let go, then Ketu Dasha can be the ideal time period, because whomsoever is supposed to leave you will leave, whomsoever is supposed to stay with you will still stay. So the ideal way of going through Ketu Dasha, either Antar Dasha or Mahadasha, you should always be in this situation of letting go. This dasha can be very good, productive in matters of spirituality. If someone is interested in meditation or spiritual pursuits, then Ketu Dasha is best, because Ketu represents all those things. Thank you. My Saturn is in Jyeshtha Nakshatra, Ketu in Hasta Nakshatra. As I said, this Saturn in the 3rd house is always good for your business kind of thing. It will push you towards business sooner or later. Okay, it may still be pushing you, but you are not going there. So this dasha or like Saturn dasha will push you towards business again and again. It is better to get into your own business, and you can have better results coming in life. Okay, I think we are done. Let me know if there is any further question or I should stop. Okay. I am meditation healing center and teacher, but Ketu Dasha scares me a lot. If I die, that's okay, but don't want to lose. Okay. This is like interesting thing. Okay, and this is commonly heard from people that if I die, there is no issue, but I don't want to lose others in my life, in my family and all. And if you logically see, okay, that was the concern of Arjun also in Bhagavad Gita, that I have to kill my own people. Okay, this is where ego resides inside us. Okay, understand, we whatever we do in our life, whatever we achieve in our life, it is not for us, it is for other people around us. Okay, a majority of our life is not for me. My life is not for me, it is for mine, whomsoever are mine, for those people. That's why in Hinduism, I and mine are considered as the biggest sin. You have to let go of I and mine. Okay, so what I am trying to say, if you are trying to save mine also, you are somehow saving your I only, your ego only. So that is, I understand that losing your relatives, your friends and all, and that is difficult, that is painful, but that is nature. Okay, whomsoever has taken birth will go from life. Okay, and I don't wish so. I am just saying that by saving your mind, you are actually saving your I only. It is not that you are ready to let go of yourself. We all are trying to save ourselves through our family members only. That's what Arjun was also doing. He was saying of things like if I kill them and all that, what will happen to this kingdom, and what will I do from this kingdom. Somewhere he was trying to save himself only. I am meditation in center. Okay, conjunction of Rahu, Sun, Jupiter in 7th house Pisces. What will be the expected result of this conjunction? Get into your own business, sir. 7th house, three planets are there. It will gravitate you towards business again and again. That can be in spiritual field, knowledge oriented field, knowledge sharing business, occult field, any these type of businesses. For Makar Lagna, okay, for Makar Lagna, Mercury Lord of 6th and 9th house, 6th and 9th house, right? If placed in 6th house, will give good results, or Bhakyesh, its results will reduce during being in Dushtana. I think it should still give good results because it is in own sign. Okay, the person may feel that he gets the support of luck after facing obstacles, but he will still have support of luck in his life. How can we now not feel pain and loss and still feel love? Very few few people would be so evolved. The detachment. Okay, you need to like. Alright, I try to explain through one story, and that will be the final for the today's session. I will just respond to the last question and then I will tell that story. It is about Baba Farid. You must be knowing about him. I went through Ketu Dasha until 2 years ago. I came close to suicide, but Ketu gave me the chance to get into humanitarian work, which I wanted to do all my life. That saved me. It was a struggle, but it made my character and life also. Right. That's what I am saying. That we need to be in a state of letting go and follow spirituality during Ketu Dasha, serving others. Serving any major, any higher cause, then that should be the way during Ketu Dasha. Now, how not to feel pain and loss and still feel love. Okay, this is a story of, I think, Baba Farid. I heard it from one of the preaching of Osho. Is where like this Baba Farid was married to a woman. I'm not sure about the mystic's name. Okay, it can be some other Sufi mystic, but let's take it as a Sufi mystic. So this Sufi mystic was married to a woman, and they were married for about 8 to 10 years. They never had a child. After 10 years of marriage, they had a son. They were both very happy, and after 4-5 years of age, that son actually fell down from the roof and died. This Sufi mystic was working in the field. He was a farmer. He was informed that your son has died. Come back and perform the last rites. So he comes back and he performs last rites. After performing last rites, he goes back to the farm and field, and he starts completing his work. In the evening, he comes back and he asks food from his wife. Okay, his wife says that he was our only son. He was born after about 10 years of marriage. I thought that you will be devastated, but you are behaving as if nothing has happened. So this Sufi mystic replied that I was happy when he was not in my life. When that child was not in my life, I was very happy. I was still very happy when that child came into my life. Then when the child has gone from my life, I am back into the situation where I was happy without a child. So understand the gist of this story. This may look like a very cruel and unemotional, detached person, but gist of the story is that whomsoever we think that they are the reason behind our happiness, they are making our life pleasant and all, we were happy even before they came into our life. So it is not that they are the reason behind our happiness. We can be happy again without them. So this is the way to get through the life, where you are finding people, you are losing people, you are again finding some people, you are again losing some. You are understand, we this is also an egoistic thought. We think that people are coming and going from our life, but we are also coming and going from many people's life. We have also left many people in our life. So at that time we never thought about it, that how other person will feel whom we are leaving. But when someone leaves us, that's where the pinch happens. Okay, so this is something to reflect upon, and it is not my intention to scare anyone. It is the truth of life. We have, and if we don't realize this truth in this time in which we are right now, then I don't think when we are going to realize it. Okay. Have a nice remaining Sunday. Enjoy and be grateful for whatever you have in your life. Okay. Take care. Enjoy. Bye.